AlKafi, when you it's classified as what? Book of Hadith, the main book of Hadith. Aslan, yani the Hadith mentality or the Hadith mind of the Shia is based on what? On AlKafi and AlBihar. True or not? Like many questions can be raised about this book, about AlKafi. But again, now it's not the time to speak about that. Especially that a lot of people are waiting to hunt. So it's not the time to speak about that in the meantime. Inshallah, I'll promise them one day we'll speak about it. So they have to keep waiting more. So I'm not going to go into the discussion of AlKafi and all the questions that can be asked about the book, the time it was published, where it was published, and so on. However, it is important to stop at one important point. Was AlKafi for Sheikh Al Kulayni, rahmatullah alayhi, written as a book of narrations or a book of rulings? Book of narrations or a book of rulings? Obviously, it's famous that it is a book of Hadith. But let us read what Al-Kulayni has to say about this. AlHur AlAmli, rahmatullah alayhi, he mentions in his book Was’el AlShia V, volume 20, page 63, that Sheikh Al-Kulayni wrote replying to the letter of someone who asked him to write a book by saying, someone sent him a letter to write a book for him. He said, as an introduction for AlKafi, for the book AlKafi. Why did he write AlKafi? He says, I have understood, O brother, what you complained about in regards to the people of our time being in a state of ignorance. They were in a state of ignorance, as all the time, it's not something new. I heard about the problems that you face, or that you have faced in reaching the rulings of your religion. So this man was living in a community where he couldn't reach the rulings or to know the rulings of his religion, and that you do not find in your place someone to ask from those who you trust in knowledge. So he had a problem of reaching the rulings of his religion, and he didn't have scholars who he trusts in his community or where he is living. You said that you would like to have a book that is enough to be followed. Kafin. And this is where the name AlKafi came from. That it is enough to be followed. Obviously, they made up this nonsense that the Imam, 12th Imam, alayhi salam, said, AlKafi kafin li shi'atina. This is where the Imam didn't say, AlKafi kafin li shi'atina. The Imam didn't even read the Kafi. Allah alam if the Sufara read the Kafi. I don't know. So there's no evidence. The Imam gave a stamp of approval. Or the Sufara, or even Al-Kulayni mentioned, if he mentioned any of the Sufara, or took from any of the Sufara in his book. I said there's a lot of questions that can be asked. But the term AlKafi, or the name AlKafi, comes from that kafin, that it is enough for people to follow. So no need to put a divine story for the name. The Kulayni said kafin, and it became kafi. That's how it is. It doesn't mean that the book is not important. But there's no evidence that it's from the Imam. Then he says, it is enough to be followed, in which it contains all the topics of religion. So it can be followed based on the authentic evidence of the truthful ones, alayhi salam, the Ahlul Bayt, authentic evidence, and which people can refer to it in their actions. Clearly, when you read this statement, that AlHur AlAmli mentioned from Al-Kulayni, you see that the purpose of writing this book is for it to be what? Resala Amaleya, fiqh. But it was written in a structure of Hadith narrations. Ahsant. There's another claim. Again, I'm not going in depth about this book. There's another claim that Sheikh Al Kulayni had access to the 400 books that are known as Al-Usul Al-Arba'mi'ah. The Shia, they believe that the scholars from the times of the Imam alayhi salam until the minor major occultation, they wrote books of Hadith. for the Shia. They are known as Al-Usul Al-Arba'mi'ah, 400 books. Now, where are the 400 books? We don't have them between our hands. There is a claim that Sheikh Al Kulayni had the Usul Al-Arba'mi'ah. And he wrote Al-Kafi based on Al-Usul Al-Arba'mi'ah. And the four main books of the Shia today that are classified as book of Hadith, and Al-Kafi for Al-Kulayni, Tahdhib Al-Ahkam for Al-Tusi, Al-Istibsar for Al-Tusi, Man La Yahduru Al-Faqih for Shaykh Al-Saduq, they say that they had Al-Usul Al-Arba'mi'ah. And based on Al-Usul Al-Arba'mi'ah, they wrote their books. So Shaykh Al-Kulayni wrote his book based on Usul Al-Arba'mi'ah. Now, why was Al-Kafi saved and preserved and reached us today, and not the 400, but if you had them between your hands, publish them, save them, protect them, same as you protected the book Al-Kafi. Where did they go? Is there evidence for Usul Al-Arba'mi'ah? Allah can make Usul Al-Khamsmi'ah. Is there evidence? I had access, I write a book and I say I had access to Al-Usul Al-Khamsmi'ah. What are the Usul al-Khamismi'ah books that scholars wrote in the past? I haven't seen the books, I have no evidence that they existed, and so on. I think it can open a big discussion about hadith, ahadith, the source of the ahadith, how to prove the ahadith, ilm al-rijal, all that stuff. And you flip the table upside down. I'm not here to do that. We're here to make you think, that's it. And make myself think too. So, Allah, he says, 400, he had access. For argument's sake, if we accept this claim, that he had access to the 400 books, we say, why didn't Al-Kulayni publish the 400 books instead of Al-Kafi? We can say, Shaykh Al-Kulayni didn't write down all the narrations of the Shia, because he was not in the process of writing a book of hadith. He was in the process of writing a book of rulings for people to follow. When you read Al-Kafi, you see Al-Bab, translated as the door. There's a title for each section, correct? The title of each section is the view of Shaykh Al-Kulayni, the ruling of Shaykh Al-Kulayni, the fatwa of Shaykh Al-Kulayni. And under each title, he puts down a group of narrations to support this view that he's presenting. So in Al-Kafi, he only mentioned his views based on his ijtihad, and he mentioned only the narrations that support his view. Now, how can you classify it as a book of hadith? Yes, it's written in a structure of hadith, but it's not a book of hadith, it's a Resala Amaleya. And this is why I say the first Resala Amaleya that is famously known is Al-Kafi. This is the first Resala Amaleya. Although it wasn't called Resala Amaleya.